Hi, I'm Flor Castillo. Welcome back to Tell It Like It Is. This week, we are discussing the upcoming 2017 municipal election. The Northampton municipal elections are to be held on Tuesday, November 7th in our own gymnasium and other locations around the city. Many of the positions up for election are mayor, city clerk, ward councilors, school committee members, and more.
However, only mayor, city clerk, and ward 6 school committee are contested.
John Riley and David Narkowicz are running for mayor. Bob Driscoll and Pamela Powers are running for city clerks.
Thomas Davidson and Lonnie Kaufman are running for ward 6 school committee.
I sat down with Pamela Powers to discuss her experience as an interim Northampton city clerk.
Well, the role of the city clerk is to oversee the operations of the office. And one of the most important things that we do here in the city clerk's office is elections. One of the things that we see when it comes to a federal election is that people are willing to come out to the polls to vote. So the turnout might be as high as 50% in the city. For a municipal election, or sometimes even a state election, we don't see as high of a turnout. So for a municipal election, especially one where there's not a lot of hotly contested races, we might see the turnout to be as little as 20%.
I also sat down with Gina Louise Sierra, a city councilor in Ward 4, to discuss how the two races, city clerk and mayor, leave the vast majority to not contested, and this present voters with little choice.
So there are only two contested races right now in Northampton. Well, that's not entirely true. There are two major contested races. There is the mayor's race and the city clerk race. There's also the Ward 6 school committee race has two people running in it, and there are a couple people who are running as write-in candidates. For one for school committee and one for city council. So there's a little bit more choice there than I think people realize. But generally, here in Northampton, we often have uncontested races. That is not unusual. This is a particularly slow year, which is kind of surprising, I think, to a lot of us, because right after the election, there was a lot of interest and the message that people were getting were, you know, the best thing you can do is get involved in local politics. And we saw, you know, in January and February, we saw a ton of people coming to city council meetings and really expressing interest in local government. And that's sort of fallen away, which is too bad. I wish that we had more interest. As I said, it's kind of a challenge. They're challenging jobs, and they are not paid as a full salary, in particular city council or school committee. So it's really something that sometimes people have to do part-time. And it's a big commitment. I would love to see a way to make our government more representative.
I went out to ask Northampton citizens about the upcoming elections to forecast results. Many people did not have a clear decision to vote. Are you planning on voting on these upcoming elections?
I hadn't planned on it. I want to, but I haven't been following it whatsoever. So,
are you planning on voting these upcoming municipal elections?
Yes.
Who are you planning on voting for?
I don't know yet. I still have to do some research.
Many senior students in NHS are already registered to vote. If you are 18 years and older, I encourage you to vote in these upcoming municipal elections. I'm Flor Castillo. Thanks for watching Tell It Like It Is.